it doesn't help either. So you cannot separate your spiritual development and physical development from your actual physical body. So we need to bring these two elements together. So the question really is the danger of that outside, or is the danger within us? And here I have to take some, I have to protect government in that way, because what we do, and I said that before in the talks I gave, we in fact empowering at the moment government agencies and regulators completely with our complacency. And the first step we have to take is to get out of the fear zone. Fear is the most paralyzing element at the moment in society and in yourself. And to get out of the fear zone requires a very simple step. And this simple step is say no. What are they going to do? That's the interesting thing. What are they going to do if you say no? So we discussed before in some of these panels the questions of how can we change that, how can we change government, and there's these regulations, and then you cannot do anything there. And I can tell you, you can. Yes. Sorry that I have to use that. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Unfortunately, with Obama, it looks like as if he can. For a very simple reason, if you look at where Obama, for example, is coming, I'm getting here in politics, where Obama came from is that his campaign was, his highest campaign contribution came from the pharmaceutical industry. And that gets you an understanding that I think is the kind of factor we need to build in before we condemn him, but at the end, this is the reality that when you get financed by forces like that, at the end, there's not much you can change, okay? So developing an inner independence and freedom as a spiritual reality, we're not talking about freedom driving on the left side on the road when everybody drives on the right side of the road. That is not the issue here. The issue here is, do we understand what spiritual freedom really means? And that is where I say we need to understand that empowerment we can get when we take the step to say positively no. And that is, and I'm speaking here from experience, so I'm not preaching to you something what I read. I'm speaking to you from experience that it empowers even other people. It empowers judges. It empowers other lawyers. It is something which has gripped a lot of people when they realize that their change is possible. So, that brings me to your questions. I hate long speeches because everybody gets tired. So, I want to encourage you to ask questions. I can give you a little bit more details if you ask about the question how to get involved and how to become responsible for your own food. The thing you please need to understand, if you ask for government protection, you're giving away your own responsibility for your own life. Governments have been designed originally, and I think in the US it's even better designed than here in Canada, because we come out of the Victorian tradition. In the US, a remarkable document, the Declaration of Independence. And to just give you an idea, we just launching this coming week, together with the independent small producers, farming producers, be announcing our Declaration of Independence as small producers of farm products. And so we encourage you to be part of that, to basically develop a free exchange that means buyer beware and farmer beware. So basically meeting each other at the farming level or at the farm gate level or at the farm producers, farm markets level, to carve out that little niche So that will be announced next week, Ontario-wide, and then hopefully a few weeks later, Canada-wide, and we also actually are launching that in the U.S. also as a declaration. So there is a lot of movement towards claiming back the rights we have. We never gave away the rights. I don't know if you know that. We never gave it away. But we consented to it by silence. And that is the historical difference. And it's an historical moment in the history of mankind that in North America, we have established a dictatorship by consent. Mm-hmm. Because we didn't speak up.
That's right.
Because we were complacent. And that is what is so remarkable, because in Russia, in Germany, wherever, it was usually by overthrowing the government, somebody established the dictatorship. And here, we actually offering that, come on, do you, rule me. We gave them all the power above us to do whatever. And every time we ask for protection, or we say, well, somebody, the government should protect me against corporate control. What is that question? You can do that. Nobody forced you into that. So I'm closing with that, and open the floor for a lot of interesting questions. Yes?
Could I please just say something first? If you're asking a question, it would be nice if you step to the microphone in the center of the room. In lieu of that, if you can't get there, Michael, please repeat the question so that other people can have it. And I just want to say, if you agree with Michael's philosophy, please do see his booth upstairs, the back left-hand side of the room, because he has a couple of petitions that you may want to sign. I urge you.
Michael, I know that, of the few farmers that are left relative to that 2%, there's still many who don't have the standards that you have for food. I wondered if you could describe to people a little bit about the actual things you do in your farm to keep that quality of food so great.